Hey guys, you're watching the one and only. My name is AJ, and we are back on another sort of tutorial-y how to build the sort of typey episode-y sort of thingy. And we're back with a underwater house. A lot of you asked me how to build one. Where do I start? What's the best way to go about it? And I've never built one before. I've never built an underwater house before, and I thought I'd have a crack at it. And this is what I came up with. So I came up with a very sort of modern-looking design. So I used the snow and very light-coloured blocks. And it's sort of only accessible by boat or by swimming. So I've got a couple of boats here, sort of yin and yangy sort of style on the top, sort of, in a way. And we've got sort of every farm. We've got like a little cactus farm, little wheat farm, little camp stove there with for them. Some wheat, a couple of trees out here, our nether portal, pumpkin, melon. So all of our main necessities, all of our minimum stuff that we need, we've got here. And then we've got like a little igloo sort of entrance. We can pop down here. And we go into our house, our beautiful looking house. So I've got a round design here. We've got windows going out to the water outside. We can actually see it is night, but in the daytime, you can actually see there's the iron golem farm there, and you can see the mountains. And it's very beautiful down here. Used sugarcane because, I don't know, sugarcane is a very sort of modern looking plant. It's a very modern colour, the light green. And I thought it sort of looked a little bit like seaweed as we're doing an underwater house. I thought it was a very sort of water-type plant, water-based block. But we've got everything we need down here. We've got enchantment and brewing. We've got storage, crafting table. We've got smelting area, cooking area. We've got our bed, done a triple bed. And in the middle here, we need a TV, don't we, with our little coffee table. So, it's the sort of design I went for. It's not the easiest thing to start off building. I was stuck for a little bit on what's the easiest way on how to build this. Because of all the water, and the easiest way that I sort of come across is as follows. We're gonna pop over here. Let's pop here. It's raining! It's raining, man. Hallelujah. Okay, so let's pretend that we're in survival here. Let's jump so we're not flying anymore. And I'm gonna use snow like I used on the last one here because it's a very modern look. It's a very modern looking building, so snow's a very modern looking block, and I think it's the best one to use. But when we're in water, we can't place blocks very easily. But there's one tip I can give you, which I use an awful lot whenever I'm building in water, whenever I'm building boats or houses, is to place the lily pad down, and then we can place the block on top of the lily pad. Really, really handy little tip. Pretty much the only useful thing that lily pads are really for. But it's a really good tip, especially when building boats out in deep water. Really, really handy. So let's build a smaller circle now. What I'll try and do is, if I can remember, is link the description to a circle generator that I use in the description below, and you put in however wide you want it to be, whatever the diameter, if you want it odd or if you want it even, and it'll work it out for you. So if I can remember, I shall put that in the description, and we're just going to build a smaller circle here for tutorial purposes. You can make this as big as you want, but the bigger you make it, the more difficult it is, and the longer process it's going to take to get all the water out of the circle. So I would probably recommend starting off with a small one, and you can always enlarge it, I suppose. It'd probably be the easiest way. So we're going to have this size 4 circle here. What we're going to do is we are going to go down a couple. Let's do the same sort of entrance style as what we've done on the last one. So we've got our boat is going to go in here. So we want to come down with enough room to let the boat in, like that. And then let's have enough room for the stairway. Remember in the igloo we had the stairway going down, so we'll have it to about there. So that's 3-4 underneath the surface. And then let's get some glass, and let's use some glass here. And we're going to have the windows, how high should we have them for this one? That's 3 layers, 4 layers, 5 layers. Yep, 5 layers sounds good. Now, if you are doing this in survival, there's a couple of things I can suggest is carry torches with you. They're the best thing when building underwater. If you place a torch on a block, it'll actually give you a little air pocket to be able to fill up your bubbles, so you don't have to keep going up to the surface, because you're going to be underwater a lot in this build when doing it in survival. So make sure that you've got torches on you, and make sure you collect them up again, and you should be able to stay down here forever. I would also recommend getting an Aqua Infinity, or whatever they are, enchanted helmet. because they'll come in handy too. Okay, so let's have some snow blocks underneath that, and then have the floor level. So we're going to come out one wider here. Take that one away, and that's back down to the bottom again. Okay, so that's our basic shape, and what we're going to do is we're going to go all the way around the outside with that design, and I shall do that, and I shall be right back. I don't think I need to show you how to do that. It's still raining, but I have completed it. We've got it going all the way down and all the way on the inside here we can see. And now it's about emptying it out. Now, if you're building the generic dome, now there is another type of underground house, and I'm sure you've seen it. They like giant domes under the ground with tunnels to other domes. You build them in exactly the same way. You're going to have to build the outer shell, and then you're going to have to fill them up to get rid of the water. So there's many different ways you can do it. Some people use like dirt blocks to get rid of them. Some people do all sorts of way, turn it into cobblestone. I've seen. I don't know. The easiest way I found is to get sand or gravel. Now sand's a lot easier to get to find, and it's just a matter of let's do it as if it was in survival. I would get some dirt, and I'd pull it out like this, and then I'd just sand it like this. Probably, well, you sort of do it anyway because you're just going to want to fill this whole place up with sand. And the reason I use sand is because one, it saves you going underwater and swimming around underwater placing blocks because it's ever so difficult to do. And two, sand is a lot easier to break than dirt, especially underwater. Okay, so I've been going for just under 10 minutes now. We're getting to the end. And new tactic. Easiest tactic now is to double tap your left trigger like that and you place two. Much quicker. It's sort of twice as quick as what I was doing before, and it does it in no time. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. And you sort of place one above the one that's falling, and then it really doesn't take long at all. I think we're nearly there. And boop. Okay, so it's completely full of sand now, which will get rid of all the water. What we're going to do is we're going to go across here just to blank out the water from coming in once we've destroyed it all. And yeah, it's just a matter of destroying it. Now, the other reason for using sand is because we can go right down to the bottom, right down to here, get our torches, and we break the sand and then place a torch. So it's exactly the same in creative. I'm in survival, but it's I'm in creative, but it's exactly the same in survival, sorry. It just takes a little bit longer to break the sand. So you break it and place a torch underneath it, and it drops all the sand onto the torch and makes a nice pile. So it's really, really quick to get rid of, much quicker than using dirt. Pow, pow. If you place it too quick, it just sort of places under it and doesn't do anything. There we go. Okay, so we're pretty much done here. Oop, yep, got it. And these ones, I think. I don't think this is going to let the water in, is it? Nope. Last few here. Really doesn't take long at all. Should have really kept it all on camera. I could have. All right, and then there we go. So we have our hollowed out area here. Really nice looking. And from here, it's probably a good point to start if you wanted to make tunnels going to domes, different domes, or different. I don't know, can, we call this like a can shape, isn't it? If you were to do different ones and domes underneath the water, it'd be probably a good place to start here, or you can complete one first and then extend out as you needed to. It doesn't really matter too much. But yeah, here's a great little starting point. So from here, you can pretty much do as you want. I would recommend getting a floor down. We're going to have the floor on this. No, let's have it one down. We'll have the ground on this level. Oh, and it sneezed. Oh. Achoo. 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 I think that's it. I think that's it. Okay, so let's just put this floor down. And then I'll show you what I did with the top of mine. We might do a little bit of a different design because this is a bit of a smaller circle, a smaller area to build in than my last one. I like snow. It's a very modern looking block for these modern looking ones. I don't think it would really suit a wooden one, a wooden dome in the water or whatever. Wouldn't suit. I think it has to be snow and glass and very modern looking blocks. Ice maybe. Some ice might work here and there. Okay, so that's our starting point. Let's flood this out, get our grass ready. And let's have our grass coming out. We're going to have a sort of same design as last time. No, let's go out another one. Let's have two. And then three. We're going to have more grass this time. Now we'll go along to there. Yeah. And there. I think that's a pretty good shape. Alright. And then fill this bit up with grass. We've got a block gap in between here and here. In between the snow and the dirt. Doesn't matter. It's nice to have a little bit of a gap, because then your stairway leading down, you'll understand when you actually start building it, will be a lot easier. As well, I'm using dirt. If you're gonna get grass, you're gonna have to get silk touch, or build a bridge. I mean, the easiest way will probably be to build a bridge of dirt from one point all the way over, and then let the grass grow naturally if you don't have silk touch. But if you do have silk touch, all you need to do is put one piece of grass in there, and that'll spread from there. The other one that I done on the last one was I had glowstone in here just to make it look a little bit more pretty, so we could place some glowstone about evenly. Make sure it's even, otherwise it can look a little bit odd. Where's my snow go? Where'd my snow go? Where'd my snow go? Eh. The aesthetics is completely up to you. Here and here. Alright, and then let's build this edge out of the dirt. Alright, and then it's a matter of flooding the area. Now, flooding the area, there's two different ways to do it. If we get some water, you can either go round the edges and slowly make your way inwards, or you can fill the bottom up so the water is only one deep, and then you can just place the water on top. It doesn't really matter what way you do it. I find doing around the perimeter first. This is how I always do my water. And then I place some random blocks down, and then place water on top, and that usually fixes most of the problems. And you just keep going until you're pretty much there. In fact, from now we might be able to just fill in some here, and it'll even out itself. All right, and it's all done there. So we now have our entryway in. And for this one, because we haven't got as much room, I'm going to use a trap door and some snow blocks still and some ladders. Let's grab some ladders. Okay, let's burst a hole in the top. Let's get a stone slab here as well. Let's have it there. That's where our hole's going to be. Trap door goes on there. I got a trap door. There you go. Break it. Oops. Place these around here. Let's go around the edge as well. Yeah. We'll do that in a minute. We'll do the outside properly in a minute. And let's have the stairway down, the ladders down here. Get rid of that torch. Alright, and now we have our way in and our way out. All sorted. So I don't think I really need to show you any more from here. You could do your own ceiling designs, your own lighting designs, your own furniture inside. You could split off into different rooms, different tunnels, going all sorts of different ways. Or you can keep it how I've done it and just keep it as one hut and have everything all on here. So I've got all my farms on the top here, got nether portal, got a couple of trees for wood. And it looks really cool. I tell you what would look really cool as well is getting some glass and actually making this into an entire dome around the top. So it looks like a sort of turtle shell of glass out of the top of the ocean. I think that would be a really cool design. So I'd love to see some of your guys' designs on this. If you do build this in Creative or Survival, send me in a picture. You can either email it to me. My email I'll put in the description below. Or you can tweet it to me, which is the easiest way. If you tweet it to me, my Twitter is in the description below. If you're not following me on there already, do follow me on there. You get some interesting things come up now and again from me and from the other guys. And you can see when I'm doing open parties long before you get a message on Xbox. I always tweet it out first. But yeah, we're going to leave it there, guys. So if you enjoyed it, hit that like button. If you haven't already, please subscribe, and we shall see you in the next episode, where we shall have another building tutorial. I've got something else special planned, so I shall leave you guys on the edge there. But that's it for now. Bye!